Amen. Church, I greet you all in the precious name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Can we take our reading from the book of 2 Corinthians chapter 5 from verse 20? It says, "Now then, we are ambassadors for Christ, as though God did beseech you by us. We pray you in Christ's stead, be you reconciled to God, for he had made him to be sin for us who knew no sin, that we might be made the righteousness of God in him." Amen. What a glorious thing, amen. Christ, who knew no sin, has been made sin for us, amen. For our sake, amen. Who knew no sin, the Bible says, that we might be made the righteousness of God, amen. And we can see in 2 Corinthians chapter 6 from verse 1, Paul is saying, "We then as workers together with him beseech you also that you receive not the grace of God in vain," amen. So we have received not the grace of God in vain. It was not in vain, amen. But we ought to be ambassadors for Christ, amen. We are manifesting the very life of Christ, amen. It says, "For he saith, I have heard thee in a time accepted, and in a day of salvation have I succored thee. Behold, now is the accepted time," amen. God is saying, "Behold, now is the accepted time," church, amen. Now is the accepted time. Now is the day of salvation, amen. Shall we pray? Gracious God and eternal Father, once again, Father, we are so privileged, O God, to come before your throne of mercy, Father. We're so privileged, O God, to call upon that mighty name, O God, that once was so powerful that man could not even mention that name, O Father. But we can come before thee, O Father, not in our own righteousness, but taking on your righteousness, O God, that we could call upon the mighty name of Jesus, Father. Bless your word. Bless it to our hearts, Father. Remove me from this way. Speak through me, Lord Jesus. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. So Church of God, amen. Now we see the time we're living in, amen. 2020 might seem as such a bad year for everybody, amen. From the year, from the time this year began, amen, it has been nothing but hardships, amen. And we see sicknesses and diseases came in, flooding in, amen. And here, all these things that we went into lockdown and we went through all these things we faced, amen. Many people is facing the situations of losing their job, amen. Many people facing situations, amen, and the bonds not being paid, the rent has not been paid, amen. Many people have been facing situations, amen, beyond their control. This year may seem, amen, as if it's just bringing in all the bad, amen. But Church of God, Paul says, amen, it says, this is the accepted time, amen. This is a time of the Lord, amen. This is a time, amen, near rapturing time, amen, as the world is getting chaotic. But the church is being prepared, amen, to go home, amen. God is preparing us. He's taking us out of our comfort zone, that we might become edgy and agitated, amen. That we may look to him, amen. That we may be raptured. He's pushing us into that rapturing, into that perfect, the stage of a perfect man, amen. So we could be raptured home, amen. And here he says, this is a time, accepted time, amen. Now is a day of salvation, amen. There's still room at the cross, church. While there's blood on the mercy seat, amen. Look to Jesus, amen. We see, we go to John chapter 9, where it says Jesus went to the blind man, and here he passes this blind man, and the disciples asked him, "Lord, what has this man sinned, or his parents sinned? Why is he blind, amen?" And Jesus tells them, "No, this man has not sinned, nor his parents had sinned, amen, but he's been blind, been born blind, because the works of God may be manifested, amen. And it might be manifested, and they might see the glory of God." But here when Jesus spits onto the clay, and he makes a mud ball, and he rubs it upon this man's eyes, amen. And here this man, he began to see afterwards. And we see what an uproar it caused within that town, amen. And the Pharisees and the Jews and everybody came before him, and they began to question him, and they began to question his parents, amen. And we see from verse 16, John chapter 9, 16, it says, "Therefore, some of the Pharisees This man is not of God because he kept not the Sabbath. So now they trying to accuse Jesus because he heals man on the Sabbath. Amen. They say no, this man sinner is a sinner because he's not keeping the Sabbath. Amen. But they didn't realize that the Sabbath was right there in front of them, performing the very works of God. Amen. And here he says, how can a man that is a sinner do such miracles? And there was division among them. They said unto the blind man again, what sayest thou of him, that he had opened thine eyes? He said, he is a prophet. But the Jews did not believe concerning him. They had been blind and received his sight until they called the parents of him. So they didn't believe that this man was being born blind, amen, until they had to go to his parents, and they began to seek his parents and say, and they asked him, saying, is this your son, who you say was born blind? How then do it now see? His parents answered him, and he said, we know that this is our son, and that he was born blind. So they testified, this is our son, he's been born blind, amen. And he says, but by what means he now seeth, we know not. Can you imagine, amen? Jesus performed the miracles. His parents knew that he's been born blind, but they're too scared to testify the works of God, that they might be kicked out of the synagogue, amen. Too many times, amen, we want to hold on to our creeds and our dogmas, amen. We don't want to be kicked out of our churches, amen. But we got to stand with the word of God, no matter what may come, amen. No matter what challenges we face, or whatever the situation will be, we ought to stand on every promise of God, on every word of God, amen. And here they say, amen. We go down to verse 25, and here the blind man, he says, he answered, he said, whether he be a sinner or no, I know not. Oh, church of God, but one thing I know that, amen. I once was blind, but now I see, amen. Though this, all these other people, amen, they come up with all these stories about Christianity and about the message, amen. But church of God, amen, we could stand here this evening and we could say, amen, we was once blind, amen. We was once sinners, amen. We was once rotten to the core, amen. But now we see, amen. We can testify of the living God, amen, that has been made flesh, that has quickened us from death unto life this time, amen. We could stand like this man says, amen, I was once blind, but now I know I can see, amen. He's standing and he's testifying the very works of the living God that has been made manifest in his life, amen. Who else can testify of these things than the bride of Jesus Christ, amen? We can say we was once dead, amen. We were once lost in creeds and man-made traditions, amen. But now we have been quickened from death unto life, amen. Oh, God has personally come and revealed himself to us, amen. God has personally come and made this message a personal relationship with his sons and daughters, amen. It's more than just words, amen. It's more than just written words written in the Bible, but it's God's manifested life among his believers, among his bride, amen. Being made alive today among the bride, amen. We see, church of God, amen, the time the eagle goes to, amen. We have many preachers preaching about this, amen. When the eagle goes through a moping period, amen. And we see this time when the eagle goes through that moping period, amen. He has to make a choice, amen. You see that he has to make a choice, amen. He either dies or he goes and he fights, amen. And here he goes through a painful process, amen. And here the eagle, amen, his beak has been blunted, amen. And his feathers upon his chest that he cannot fly, amen. That's what the devil likes to do too many times to the believers, amen. He makes you bogged down with burdens, amen. He makes your chest heavy with worries and sorrows and burdens and all these things. But church of God, amen, take your burdens and leave it there, amen. Take it to the feet of Christ and leave it there, amen. Too many times we carry unwanted baggage, amen. Like that professor once says, he says, oh, what is the weight of this cup of water, amen? And the people came up with different answers. But he says that's not important. What important is how long you hold that water in your hand. And the longer you hold that water, the heavier it gets, amen. If you're holding it for a few minutes, it's a light cup of water. You're holding it for an hour, it's still light, amen. But then as time goes by, few hours, 3 hours, 4 hours, it gets heavier. A day, it gets heavier till your arm becomes paralyzed, amen. And that's what burdens does to the believers, amen. It bogs you down. It clouds our judgment, amen. It clouds our vision, amen. But we don't look to our natural. We don't look to short-sighted, but the bride of Christ is far-sighted, amen. Looking to our future home, amen. Looking to the promises of God. Standing on the promises of God, amen. So this time that this eagle goes through, amen, we would liken it unto the wilderness stage, amen. When the children of Israel came into the wilderness church of God, amen, they've been delivered, they've been set free from their bondage. God has answered their prayers, amen. And yet when they come into the wilderness, can you imagine, amen? The Bible says they walked 40 years into the wilderness and their shoes perished not, amen. And their clothes perished not, amen. That's what kind of God we serve. God was sustaining them. But they was not looking to the heavenly vision. They was not looking to the promises of God. But they began to look behind them. They began to look behind them. And that is why it took them 40 years. Because they were looking behind them. They began to stumble and fall. Too many times when we look behind us, amen, we begin to stumble and fall, amen. But if you keep your eye on the promises, church of God, amen, through your wilderness, you will come out through the promised land. They had to go through that wilderness stage, but they was looking behind them, amen. We ought to stop looking behind us, church of God. Stop looking to the world, amen. Stop looking to what we were. Stop looking to the worries, amen. Stop looking to all the distractions of Satan, amen. But look unto your promises. Look unto the promises of God. Look to your heavenly vision, amen. Look to your heavenly home, amen. God has prepared a place for us, amen. Look to that heavenly vision, amen. Don't look to the back, amen, but look to the promised land. And this eagle, amen, when he goes through that moping period, he can either look back, amen, and look at what it was or what it used to be and how high it used to fly, amen, and what a mighty predator it used to be, amen. But now he's all bogged down and he's heavy, he's burdened and he cannot fly, amen. And Satan likes to do that to the believers. But church of God, we have to go through that period, through that wilderness. But when we're in that situation, the most important thing is to realize or look to the promises of God, amen. Like when you're in a storm. When Peter was in the storm, he had his eyes fixed on Jesus, amen. When your eyes is fixed on Jesus, it doesn't matter what situation we're facing, amen. It doesn't matter how high the tides get, amen. It doesn't matter how dark the night gets, amen. But we are looking through the morning, for the joy cometh in the morning, amen, the Bible says. And here, this eagle, it goes, it either dies or it perseveres and it goes through this painful process. And it begins to fly into the mountaintop on his nest, amen. And it begins to beat his head and hit his beak against the wall and beat and beat and beat his head, amen, until it's all bloody, amen, until all that old beak is fall away and it begins to grow a new beak, amen. Now, if he kept looking back at his what it used to be, amen, he can go down in a ditch, in a valley, and he can just die. Because this is a time, amen, a crucial time of that eagle's life, amen. But he doesn't look to what it was, amen. But he looks to what he will be once he's come. He has overcome this challenge, amen. The eagle keeps his eye on the promise, amen. If I go and I beat my head, I will beat my head against a rock till my beak fall off, amen. And then when my talons grow off, I will rip off those old feathers that's bogging me down, amen. We are to rip the feathers of Satan, church of God. We are to rip the burdens of Satan that's bogging us down, amen. Look to your future. Look to the promise, amen. God, the Bible says, God saw you without spot or wrinkle, without blemish, amen. God has saw you as pure and white, amen. He has a bride, amen, that is looking forward to see, amen, to meet, amen. And that's what we ought to be focusing on, church, amen. And we see, amen, if God has, oh, the prophet of God says, amen, if God has delivered you from sin, how much more he can deliver you from your sickness, amen. If he's able to change your nature from a wicked man or a woman, amen, and change your nature, change your heart's desires, amen, how much more he can change your natural ability, amen. That's a power of Almighty God we serve, amen. That's the power of our Savior, amen, our Redeemer, amen. And we see the prophet of God tells us, amen, we see the church of God, amen, the churches have become so lukewarm, amen, so contaminated with the world, amen, that it's nothing more than just a worldly program, amen. The prophet of God says, amen, he says, there was a time the prophet of God says that the lady had a little baby, amen. And she began to take him to the store and she rang a bell in front of him and she put all odds, things that would normally attract a child and all colorful pictures and stuff. And she put in front of this baby, but this baby will just stare at this picture, or he'll just stare into space, amen. He'll just look dead with no emotion, amen. And this lady began to cry and the people said, "Lady, what is wrong? What is wrong with the baby?" And she says, "No, the doctor told me that my baby will be well. I must just need, he had a spell bound, amen, that every now and again he'll go into a spell, he'll be dazed, amen, there'll be nothing in front of him, amen, but nothing will attract his attention, he just stares." And he says, "The doctor told me that he would be better. I brought him down here to pick up the little gadgets to attract him, but still, that's..." And he just stares at this gadget, amen. The prophet of God says, that's the way the church is getting. God has shook every promise in the Bible before them. Still, we just sit and stare. Can you imagine how the church is looking at now, amen? God has shook every promise in the Bible before them. Still, we just sit and stare. He says, "Show me a sign, will you?" And it's going in all the time, right around us, bringing the presence of God. It ought to illuminate us. When God made a promise, he stands by that promise, amen. We see God is faithful to his promise, amen. Church of God, no matter what situation we're facing, amen, the prophet of God says, don't you realize, friends, and recognize that God has come down in the gospel, amen, in his people, making himself known, amen. Can't you recognize the hour we're living in, amen? Hey, the prophet of God preaches in 1964. Can't you realize the hour that you'll be living in now? But church of God, how much more closer we are to being raptured in this day and age, amen. In 2020, we see the world, the stage is set for the rapture, amen. We see, he says, have we just got ourselves off to clap our hands a little bit? He's talking about the condition of the churches nowadays. Have we just got ourselves off to clap our hands a little bit? Play the piano and recite this and got away from the word till we that blind to it. Surely we not. He says, let's recognize the hour that we're living in, amen. Paul says it's the hour of acceptance, amen. It's the hour that we're living in, amen. The prophet of God says, a man that believes God can see the presence of God. Hallelujah, amen. That is why too many times people can't see the presence of God, amen. Because he doesn't believe God, he doesn't stand on that word, amen. He says, a man that believes in God can see the presence of God, feel the presence of God, sense the presence of God, and know that he is here. He is here to answer everything that he made promise of for this in this day. Amen. He says, then cry till you get it. Amen. Hold on to him. Don't leave if you have to stay day and night. God don't want his children to listen to intellectual speeches, amen. Too many times we want to listen to great motivational speakers and intellectual speeches and intellectual sermons, amen. But the prophet of God says, amen, God don't want his children to listen to intellectual speeches, amen. He wants them to cry out to cry out to him, amen, till the promise is made, till the promise is being vindicated, amen. We ought to hold on to the promises of God, amen. The prophet of God says, hold on to everything, amen. Cry till you get it, amen. He says, even if you have to stay day and night, amen. He says, stay in there and cry till you get it, amen. Till the very promise has been vindicated, amen. Church of God, that's what's the hour. It's a time of accepted, amen. It's an accepted time. It's a day of salvation, amen. The hour that we are living in now, amen. The prophet of God says, the genuine Christian, you don't have to baby him or pet him and tell him this or tell him that or the other. He's got something in him. The baptism of the Holy Ghost that throws all the rest off. He says, don't have to beg him around because he's a genuine plant of God. He's got something in him that was. A Christian fights for every inch of ground that he stands on, amen. We ought to fight this evening, amen. Fight on every ground. Don't let Satan rob you for your blessings, amen. The prophet of God says we live a million miles below our God-given privileges, amen. But it's time, amen, the bride of Christ, she stands on the ground, amen, and fights for every inch of it, amen. He says he's got something in him that was. A Christian fights for every inch of ground he stands on. He must do that if he ever expects to exist. And by doing it, there is something in him that takes care of him. Oh church, what a God we serve, amen. What a mighty God that we serve. In the same sermon, the prophet of God says, so God has made a way for us, amen. God loves his children. He loves his people. He wants to help them. He wants to help you more than you want help. Can you imagine, amen? God wants to answer your prayer more than you want your prayers to be answered, amen. He says if you can just get in your heart, get that in your heart, that God is more willing to help you than you are to help yourself. But he has a way, and that's the only way he'll do it. That's the only way he'll work through his way. You must come to his terms, not your own terms, amen. His terms. He says you want it in a certain way, but he gives it to you in his way, amen. Like there was one time Naaman, amen. He had the leprosy, and he went, and this little girl told him, amen, there's a prophet of God that's been healing, praying for the people and healing them. And this Naaman went to him, amen. And he expected the prophet of God to tell him some great thing, to do some great thing. But he says, go in the river Jordan and dip yourself 7 times, amen. And Naaman was offended. He says, is there not any clean rivers where we come from that I have to go in the river Jordan and dip myself now? And this little girl said to him, but master, if the man of God had told you to do something great, you would have done it, amen. Why not just do this little simple thing, amen? And here he went and he dipped himself, and on the 7th time when he came out, he has been completely cleansed, amen. But God, he says, that's why the prophet of God says, amen, God will meet you on his terms, amen. Not on our own terms, amen. God always answers our prayers, amen. Even if it's with a no, amen, God answers our prayers. Even if it's in his own time, amen, God answers his prayers. He knows, amen, the end from the beginning, amen. That's what a mighty God we serve, church, amen. That's what a powerful God that we serve, amen. There was once a story of this old man, amen, during the time of Christmas. This old man, he had TB, and he was so weak in body and so sickly that nobody wanted to hire him. He couldn't work, amen, and he became a tramp. And him and his family began to live out on the streets in the back part of the alley, amen. And this man, he should sell all odds and ends, selling on the streets, amen, pins and needles and belts and all these odd sorts, amen. Make a few pennies here and a few pennies there, amen. Just to survive, just to provide for his family, amen. And this man got so sick, amen, that he passed this disease to his wife. She began to get sick with TB, amen. And she died later on, amen. And here, it comes a time of Christmas, amen. And this man, he's... he's trying to sell and provide for his daughter and himself. And things are just so bad. So he's getting more and more sick. And here his daughter becomes sick with TB, amen. And here, because of the cold, she picks up pneumonia. It's a time where it's snowing and it's really cold, amen. And here, in this back part of alley, amen, we see all the, during Christmas time, amen, all the rich kids are getting all these expensive toys and expensive clothing, expensive, all these expensive dolls. And this child, amen, she's being about 10 years old, never had a doll in her life. But she just wanted this Christmas time, she just wanted a doll as a gift, amen. Whatever doll it was, she just had a desire of having a doll, amen. Like the rest of the kids, amen. Being so poor that this father began to know it's coming time of Christmas. So he began to work and save and just sell a few odds and ends and save whatever pennies he can just to get this teddy bear or this doll for his daughter, amen. And he knows that he don't have much time because pneumonia has set in and she's quickly perishing, amen. She's quickly getting very ill, amen. And here he knows he's working long hours, amen. He's trying all that he can just to get as much money as he can just to buy his daughter this little doll, amen. Even if he doesn't eat, amen. Even if he doesn't care about himself, amen. Though he needs medication and he needs all sort of medical attention, but he's so poor that he'd rather focus, you know, he lost his wife and here he's losing his baby girl. And here he's trying to do all that he can for this little daughter of his, amen. And here she soon, amen. It was too late that she soon died, amen. And here when she dies, amen, this man he threw him over the edge, amen. And just losing his wife and now he loses his daughter, the only thing that he had left. Amen. And here he goes home to his little old back alley, amen, staying probably like in a shack or off on the streets, amen. And he goes to the tiny home and he sees that his ton of money that he's been saving for his daughter, amen. And just looking at this money, amen, it just breaks into 1,000 pieces, amen. But Church of God, we know that when a man comes to 1,000 pieces before his feet, amen, he can leave them being made whole, amen. And we see this man, he begins to break down and it just throws him off the chart, amen. He begins to go so much in depression that he visualizes his daughter next to him and he begins to talk to her and have a conversation with her, amen. But he's in such a dark, deep state, amen. He's such in a sorrowful state, amen. He knows that his daughter, all she ever wanted was this little doll. And that one thing, he didn't get a chance to provide for her, this one doll. And he takes all that money he made that day, together with all the change that he's managed to save up, amen. Being Christmas Eve, he went into the store and he began to buy the cheapest doll that he could get. But it was all that he had. It was all the money that he had, he gave for this doll, amen. And he began to buy this doll and he holds it close to his heart. Walking down the streets, amen, he went to his house. He knows she's not there, she's already been buried, amen. And he sees she's not there. And he began to walk down the streets, amen. He knows that she's been buried, but he's looking for something, amen. He's looking for her. And he holds this doll close to his heart, walking down the streets, amen. With tears flowing down his eyes, amen. He's looking for his daughter somewhere. He's saying, oh Lord, somewhere she will be, amen. And he begins to walk down the streets while the world has been celebrating Christmas Eve, amen. The rich and famous been having drinking parties and gifts has been exchanged, amen. They're celebrating so much to be the birth of Christ, but during Christmas time, amen, more alcohol is sold than any other time in the world. What they have brought to our Lord Jesus Christ, amen. What reproach they're bringing to his name, amen. And we see this man, he begins to walk and the policeman catches him on the alley and he asks him, what are you doing this way? He says, I'm looking for my daughter, sir. I've bought her this little gift. And he asks him, where do you stay? And he says, I stay down in the alley. He says, you are going the wrong way. You must be drunk. And he began to push this man around, amen. Till he pushed him away, amen. And then till the next morning, when all the people have been woke up, amen. in the rich big houses, amen, and in the comfort house, in the warm beds, amen, and being hungover from the night before. But yeah, they didn't know that the man in the back alley, what he had been through, amen. And yeah, this man has been tossed over, lying on the street with a teddy bear in his arms, amen. And yeah, this policeman go and turn him around and you see this man is also died, amen, with a teddy bear in his arms. The prophet of God says, amen, this man has taken his present to his daughter, not on this earth, amen, but into the heavenly realms, amen. He's taken this teddy bear, he's taken that gift to her, amen, that he could go and he can meet her there. Church of God, how much more the gift of God, Christ has brought it down to us, amen. God has brought down the gift of Christ to us that we might be saved, amen. Too many times we listen to motivational speakers and motivational preachers that you will be okay and you will come out okay. But what about the word of God that Jesus says, he that turned back from the plow is not worthy of the gospel, amen. They want to live any kind of life. But church of God, amen, let us not be that like the rest of the world, amen, bringing reproach to the name of Christ. But let us embrace that gift that God has given us, amen. That we might be ambassadors of Christ, amen. That we might uphold that name of Christ, amen. That we might be a banner for God, amen. That we might be a banner unto that name of Christ, amen. The Bible says the name of the Lord is a strong tower, that the righteous run into it and they are saved, amen. So during this time, during this hour of darkness, amen, let us take on that name of Jesus. Run into that name of Jesus, amen. Shelter in that name of Jesus, amen. But it's more than just say, I am a Christian. It's more than just say, I believe on the Lord Jesus Christ, amen. It's more than just confessing with our mouth, amen. But it's a life that's being produced, amen. That it's a life that's being produced from the very inner soul, from within our soul, amen. That we would be change from our soul, amen. It's more than confessing with our mouth, but it's rather than living a life from within our soul, amen, that testifies of Christ, amen. I pray, church of God, amen, that each one of you may be blessed, amen, that we all may be ambassadors of Christ, amen, to this dark, dying world, amen. Though they come persecutions, though they come trials, amen, the Bible tells us, amen, though the enemy comes in like a flood, but God will raise up a stand against it, amen. Oh, church, shall we pray? Gracious God and eternal Father, we're so thankful once again, Lord Jesus, that we could call upon your mighty name. Father, Lord Jesus, we pray, Lord God Almighty, for the church of God, amen. We pray for your bride, amen. We see many children that's been facing persecution, been facing sicknesses and hardship, more so at this time, Father. But I pray, Lord God, that your spirit, you'll send your spirit to be with them, Father. May your Holy Spirit to come down and be our strength, be our portion at this time, Lord. We pray, Lord God, for our church. We pray for our pastor. We pray for the church around the world, amen. We pray for the each believer that's been sick and afflicted, each believer that's been going through your trials, Father. May you undertake for each one, Lord God. We pray, Lord God, may you bless your world, bless each of our hearts, Father. For we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. God bless you, church.